In today's problem, we are trying to find all non-negative integers a and b such that square root of a plus square root of b is equal to square root of 2024. This particular problem is actually from a Poland Math Olympiad 2024, and I will strongly encourage you right now to try it out for yourself and then come back and check your solutions. Alright, so let's try to solve this particular problem. Let's first write down our conditions. So, we know that both a and b are integers, and we know that a and b must be non-negative numbers. So that means that we can say that both numbers a and b must be greater or equal to zero, since, as you already know, zero is also non-negative integer. Alright, so how can we approach this problem? So I assume that most of you will say that we can first put everything to the square, but actually this would be a really bad tactic. The better tactic would be to put one unknown radical on the right side of the equation, like so. Now from here we will square our equation. And we will get the following. From here, we will develop the right side of the equation using the square of binomial, which states that the quantity of x minus y squared is equal to x squared minus 2xy plus y squared. So, if we use this on the right side of our equation, we will get the following. Alright, so now let's think about this equation for a little bit. We know for the fact that b must be an integer. We also know that 2024 is also an integer, and we know that a must be an integer. So that means that our middle term, 2 square root of 2024 a, must also be an integer. But we know that 2 is an integer number, so from here we can conclude that square root of 2024 a must be an integer. Now we will proceed by trying to somehow simplify the number 2024 by using only the product of the primes. So we can simplify number 2024 like this. So from here we can conclude that we can write down 2024 as 2 times 2 times 2 times 11 times 23. But now we can see that we have pair of primes, 2 and 2. So that means that 2 can go outside of the square root. We can also see that our other three primes, 2, 11 and 23, do not have their pair. So that means that they will have to stay inside the square root, and we can see that their product is equal to 506. Now, this means that we can simplify square root of 2024 as 2 times square root of 506 times a. But if we analyze this further, we know that 2 is an integer, and since the whole number must be an integer, this means that the square root of 506 times a must be an integer. This tells us that a must be written in a form of 506 times some number squared, which we will call x in this case. And from the condition of our problem, x must also be an integer number and it must be greater than or equal to zero, or in other words, non-negative number. Alright, but what about b? Well, if we go back a little bit, and if we notice the line number 2, you can see that we left the square root of b on the left side of the equation. But we could also choose square root of a to be on the left side of the equation, like this. So what does this change? Well, actually, our calculations will stay completely the same, only a and b will switch their places, as you can see. From here, we will get that now the square root of 2024b is an integer, which we can again simplify as before as 2 times square root of 506b, and that means that square root of 506b must be an integer. So now from this we can conclude that the value of b must also be equal to 506 times some number squared, which we can call y in this case. So from the conditions of our problem, we know that y must also be an integer and y must also be greater or equal to 0 since it is a non-negative number. Okay, so now we will use the values of a and b, and we can substitute those values back into our original equation, and we will get the following. Now we can simplify the square root of 2024 to be equal to 2 times square root of 506, as we already shown before. If we now simplify the left side of our equation by putting x and y in front of the square root, we will get the following. Here we can cancel out the square root of 506, since that is the common factor, and we will get that x plus y must be equal to 2. Now, we know for the fact that x and y are non-negative integers, so both of them must be equal or greater than 0. But since sum of those numbers x and y is equal to 2, that also means that they must be lesser than or equal to 2. Now the best thing to proceed here will be to write a table and to put the possible values for x and y. So since we know that x is an integer and has the values from 0 to 2, we can conclude that only possible values for x are 0, 1 and 2. So if x is equal to 0, that means that y must be equal to 2. If x is equal to 1, y will also be equal to 1, and if x is equal to 2, y must be equal to 0. Now we can substitute all values back into a and b, and we will get our result. So first, let's substitute the value of x as 0 and y as 2. We can simplify this to get that in this case, a will be equal to 0 and b will be equal to 2024. If we substitute the value of x to be 1 and the value of y to be 1, we will get the following expression, which means that in this case both a and b will be equal to 506. And the last one, if we substitute the value of x to be 2 and the value of y to be 0, we will get the following. And from here we will conclude that a must have the value of 2024 and the b, in this case, will have the value of 0, and those are our pairs of solutions for this particular problem. I really hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.